want, see if we can keep that clown, find that clown. All right, first question, we'll start over here this time. Go ahead.
Do you have any plans for DLC, or do you know what you're going to do with that?
I'm really, at this point, we're still just looking to ship the game. We haven't got a certification yet, and so our focus is on putting everything we can into the game and delivering the best product there. We'll start looking at DLC in a little bit. I mean, I'm sure we'll have something coming out. What that is exactly, I don't know yet. Sorry.
All right, over on this end.
Hey, I had a quick question around the single player versus multiplayer. I noticed that, like in original Left 4 Dead, the single player is really similar to the multiplayer, but it's not the AI isn't that great. Have you any improvements towards that? Is the single player any different? I mean, what's the difference?
Well, so before we had the bots where you can take a break and jump in at any time, and how those bots behaved were always the same. And now in single player, they're a little bit more like, they think of you as their boss. And so if you were playing with your boss, you would always make sure he has health, you would always take care of him. You'd always make sure, I think the biggest complaint would be if 100 pounds is you, that they get him off. And so we've made sure of all of that. And so we've delivered that. And if you play single player in particular, you can kind of stop and see the story more that unfolds. If you start from the very beginning and play through to the end, you'll be able to pick up all the little clues and nuances of what's there.
Over here.
Hey, so the original Left 4 Dead was a very linear game. Are you doing anything to make this a little bit more open-ended in the way you progress the level?
Well, so the maps all offer a lot of different ways you can go, but they do focus down into still, you know, having little points where you have to get through, and also this day you have to go through the same safe room. So in that sense, it's still the same. But we have a lot of like this area here, which is a big open place. You can choose a lot of different ways. The finale in C5, or this one, the parish, is a good example. We were running across the bridge, and it seems like it would be very linear, but there's a lot of different paths you can take through the same area, staying on top of the trucks and running alongside. So we've opened up a lot of opportunities like that.
All right, over here.
Okay, I've played Left 4 Dead for a long time and it's kind of a huge fan. But I have a quick question. What happened to Half-Life?
Yeah. Well, you're gonna announce Half-Life 3 right now, don't you?
Yes. I hate to say we like to talk about what we're know when we're delivering and talking about. We're definitely not done there. G-Man's Gordon from the future, who's Alex's brother.
Make sure to put that on the site to tell them. But next question over here.
Yeah, one of the things that I loved about the whole zombie genre and things like that is the environments. And with the movie Dawn of the Dead, there was a great environment that a lot of people who played Left 4 Dead wanted to see brought into the game sphere. Why no mall level?
Actually, you'll see that in the beginning in Savannah. You'll see that along there, and also if you want the actual Dawn of the Dead mall, there's a mod coming out for Left 4 Dead 1 that I've got to see some of that's pretty cool, called, I think they call it Crossroads Mall, and that'll be coming out any month now, not sure the exact date.
Alright, your question?
Multiplayer-wise, are you going to do anything to bridge Left 4 Dead 1 and Left 4 Dead 2 together? You know, like, do something that allows people with Left 4 Dead 1 to play some multiplayer maps on Left 4 Dead 2?
So that's something we're looking at. It's a technical thing between Steam community on our side and Xbox Live and Microsoft side. We're not there knowing the answer exactly yet. We'll be before shipping. And when that happens, someone smarter than me will be able to talk about it. So right now, I don't really have anything new on that. Sorry.
You're working on it. Next question.
Yeah, are melee weapons going to be useful on expert?
Are melee weapons?
Yeah.
Yes. If you're getting swarmed, pull out your axe and start swinging. It stuns people and sends them back. And just so you know, expert's one of those things of like when we talk about different groups of feedback. The expert players gave us very different feedback than other groups. And one of the things we're going to do there is make it a little less brutal to jump from advanced to expert. So there's some tuning there we'll give you.
Excellent. All right. Well, thank you, Chet, and thank you guys for attending Spike Sneak Peeks. Make sure to watch more game videos every week on GameTrailers.com, GameTrailers TV, Tuesday nights at 12:30, and on the 2009 Video Game Awards coming to Spike live on Saturday, December 12th. Thanks, everybody. Have a great PAX.
Thanks.